Well, hello, boys and girls. It's when I feel like it o'clock, and it's the weekend here. It's the weekend in the AM. Having myself my Joe, cup of Joe. Just getting ready for a weekend retreat for Pilates and stretching and a lot of meditation and such. Chingki's House of Pilates is putting it on, and I love that that feel, that vibe. Plus, go down to Chinky's House of Pilates there. Ask for Poon. Tell her that Perlo sent you. And I bet you they give you a free ride for the first time. I know that's. Please tell them that I sent you, though. That's how I get my free Pilates myself. We all love our free Pilates, don't we? Anyways, boys and girls, we're here about hockey, right? Of course we are. I'm Pearl of Wisdom. You're listening to my NHL Pearls of Wisdom. Free agency coming up on the 1st. And the big thing, all the buzz right now, well actually Pavelski, but I'll get into Pavelski in my next video. But I want to talk about Duchene. A lot of speculation. The big thing is that Duchene is either going to Montreal or Nashville. Okay? Montreal, I could see, I suppose, for a lot of reasons, he would be the number one guy there, so on and so forth like that. The bad thing about Montreal is the taxes. You get your ass kicked in taxes in Montreal, and that's where they're big, they have a lot of problems there, as far as drawing free agents. Fortunately for them, they're like the iconic, how's this lighting working out? That looks better. They're the iconic team in the NHL, and a lot of players just want to go there and don't worry about money, which leads me to something. How much do we worry about money? Let me tell you, okay, basically the reason why people are saying that Duchene is going to go to Nashville, it's almost like a foregone conclusion, it's going to Nashville. Is because he plays country music, he loves country, and he has a house already in Nashville. That's all fine and dandy. That's great. But what's the value of that? Because for my money, for what I'm, okay, let's say I'm Duchene. I love whatever music, okay? And I love music. I don't play music, but if I did, it would be really cool to go to a place that appreciates the kind of music I play. Sure. Now, Columbus has his rights, and has his rights for an 8-year contract. They can give him an 8-year contract. Nobody else in the league can give him an 8-year contract, including the Nashville Predators. So the Nashville Predators come out and say, we'll give you 7 years at 8. And Columbus says, we'll give you 8 at 8. And so let's just look at that, okay? You're going to give up $8 million because of your fervor for country music? Really? Like, you can't play country music in Columbus? $8 million? Just imagine, I think Duchene has got a wife and family and stuff like that. I know me, if my wife was doing something and she was going to give up $8 million because, say, my wife likes to cook. So she's going to give up $8 million because she's going to New York where the cooking is the best? No freaking way. Are you kidding me? Oh, but they're already making, what's the difference between $64 million and $70? It's $8 million. That's what the difference is, okay? I got kids. $8 million is $8 million. The difference between $64 and $72 million is a lot of money for my grandchildren, for the future children, all of those sort of things like that, because you like to sing country music. I'm sure you can find a damn good you could buy a karaoke bar for $8 million, for fuck's sakes, right? Okay, so what'll happen then is Nashville will say, we'll give you 8.5 for 7. And Columbus will match it, match it, match it. Now it's just going to get up to a number. I believe in Columbus's situation right now, they can ill afford to lose Duchene, because the only other person now on the market is Pavelski that you might be able to get. He's a 35-year-old guy. You could pay him 2-3 years, and they could do that. They could go to Pavelski and just give him a shitload, like $10 million for 2 years. And he might come with for that kind of money. By the way, Nashville, their taxes are really good too, so there is a thing there. I don't think Columbus is as much different. So anyways, if they can go to 9 for 8 years, that's 72 million. Now, in order for Nashville to even come close, they're probably going to have to go 10 or 9.75. Is Nashville willing to pay Duchene? Now you're getting to the point where is Duchene the type of center that's worth 9.75 on your team? That's going to be putting Nashville in some pretty damn tough cap situation, in a pretty damn good tough cap situation. So I think this is going to take till the end of the summer for one thing, because Nashville also can go to Pavelski and say, hey, you know, how about this? Look at us. Look at we're cup contenders, and Nashville is. Now that leads to another thing. Okay, maybe somebody's willing to give up the 8 million or whatever because they want to win a cup, and there's more chance in Nashville than there is in Columbus. But the question is there more chance? Okay, I agree. It's likely that they're not going to be able to sign Bobrovsky. Unless they're going to give him full term at 10 million. He's going to be a 38-year-old by the end of that term at $10 million. Columbus is not a team that can afford that kind of cap uncertainty. All right? They're not a team that has tons of money to buy out a player like that. That being said, Duchene is not that old. You can give him 8 years and he's probably good through his whole contract. Silly me, I forgot to check out exactly how old Duchene is. Well, I think he's 27, 28, something like that. Why didn't I look that up, you silly? Okay, anyways. He's not that old, anyways. They wouldn't likely have to buy out his contract. And they need him. You got Lehner out there. You can throw him 5 million for the next 4 years. I don't think there's any team out there that's going to be willing to do that. Maybe not even the New York Islanders. Goaltenders are easier to find. They come up on the market more. Quick is probably available. You can probably get him for not a bad price. There's lots of, and you have cap room. Werenski, sure, Werenski and Murray are not signed yet. They're going to sign Werenski. They don't need to worry about that. Murray, you can either sign him or trade him for another defenseman. And they could probably even sign your buddy there, his buddy there from Ottawa, Ryan Dzingel. And Duchene is 28 years old. So if you sign him for 8 years, he's 36. He's probably good for that. He's got good legs on him. Probably signed Dzingel for 3 years. You got your buddy there. They got not a bad team. This is a team that, okay, you're going to lose Panarin, but if you put Duchene in there instead of Panarin, the rest of the team besides Bobrovsky, if you bring in Lehner, that almost equals that up. You've got a really good chance of being a good playoff team with some cap room to improve. For a chance of going to Nashville, who is a cup contender, makes the playoffs, probably would make the playoffs consistently. But are they that much of a better team? I don't think so. I have a feeling he's going to stay in Columbus. I think Columbus is going to give him the money and he's going to use Nashville to bring the price as high as he can and take the Columbus gig. Have a great day. Oh, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, and I'll give you a vat of high, or a My NHL Pearls of Wisdom necklace. Signed by me and helicopter to your door. Have a great day. Lots of love to you.